Good evening, this is Giuseppe Basile. I'm the analyst in charge. You can find at the blog fibstalker.com. I also post regularly on Twitter using the fibstalker nickname. Good evening, today is Sunday, July the 21st, 2013, and this is a weekly review that I share with my subscribers. Those who follow me know that I always watch on the weekly chart, and I'm starting from the euro here. What you see on the screen is the weekly chart of the continuous futures contract of the euro FX. And those who follow me know that I trace and monitor carefully this 121.50 area. It acted as a support in mid of 2010 and again in July 2012. This level of support shows higher levels for the euro possible, and it's possible that for the euro to get to this 149 level. Now, since the beginning of February, we knew that there was the program trading would look at a level of support, and this level of support is indeed an area. It's not a level, and it starts from the 121.10 level down to the 127.17.16. We see here that every time price came into this area, there was participation on the long side, on the from program trading. It happened at the beginning of April, then again mid of May, and then again at the beginning of June. So this area of support here as targets in the 141.10, 141 area. So this level of target is still in place, and I believe that we won't see this 129.10 tested again, but price of the euro will start now moving higher. Now, this won't be euro weakness, but rather dollar index. Let's move to the weekly dollar chart then. And what you see on the screen is the continuous contract, and this is the contract traded on the ICE US exchange. And those who follow me know that I've been indicating this level of resistance, the 84.50, now since almost since more than a year here, and 84.50 acted as a resistance twice in 2012, and again twice in 2013. In the last 2 weeks, we saw here resistance again. I want to show on this chart also a formation that I follow. I call this formation M for Marder, and as we can see here, the next measured move on the weekly failed here when price went below this 81.47, and we had a retest of resistance, and that retest of resistance was successful. So my pattern says now that we should actually see these 80.60 levels again, and we should continue lower, and this is compatible with the euro that keeps moving higher. The SP 500 was a surprise in one sense. We knew that the sequence of measured move of the daily had failed, and we knew that when we saw price moving below this 160, sorry, 1620 level. And those who follow me know that I've called this in the past. The daily sequence of measured move higher failed, but program trading actually picked price at the next weekly level, and that was in the 1565 area. Actually, there are two different ways of tracing this because of the behavior of program trading on the daily. So I like to consider both these trades, but basically, support came around these two levels, which are very close one another, and the first one would be 1565, and the lower would be 58. So But basically, as we can see, these two, this area brings price in the same area of target, which is going to come between 1610 and 30. So we could definitely get some sort of retrace or profit taking from these levels. Yes, as this setup, long setup we saw here, and we saw participation the first 4 weeks ago, and then again in the coming 3 weeks, in the next 3 weeks, this setup is an extension. So there is a possibility for price to get into 1710, 1730, and then after maybe some profit taking, continue higher into the 1690, up to 1820. So area. So I've explained this in my newsletter. So read the detailed trading plans. And so this is it for the SP500. So we should see a continuation higher, some profit taking the 1630 here. To close the US dollar versus the Canadian dollar, we know that we have a long term resistance that is traced from the 2009 highs to 2011 lows, and as you can see, these levels can be identified with years in advance sometime, and we had participation in the one on the shorts and in the 105.60 area, and again at the same area we had participation on the downside. So this is not only because there is participation here, but there are previous price here and previous size, but because we know that these levels we get participation. So we will generally see now continuation lower if the dollar is to continue lower here. So the Canadian dollar should gain against the US dollar. This is it for the weekly review of today, Sunday, July 21st, 2013. If you want to receive this video, you can subscribe my free newsletter. Go to my website. On the left side you'll find a picture. Click on it, and it takes 10 seconds to register. Provide me with your email, and I'm going to send the review, the weekly review. Thanks a lot for watching the video, and see you soon. Bye bye.